For our signal project, we need to be able to pull information for reporting and see data easily on one page to visualize progress. In the introduction, we touched on how things are organized by entity, an entity being a shot, a sequence, an asset, a level, an episode, a task, a time log. Within each entity, we'll be tracking all the information pertaining to them using shotgun fields. Each of these entities and their corresponding fields can be connected. In Signal, we're tracking assets as well as the tasks required to create those assets. A single asset typically contains multiple tasks, like the warrior dress asset. Let's head to our task page in Shotgun, which contains all of our asset tasks. Since the tasks are linked to the asset via the link field, we can pull information from the asset onto the task that it's linked to. From here, we want to see the status of the asset these tasks are linked to. First, we'll click on the Fields dropdown and scroll down to the bottom of the section called Linked Fields. Tasks are linked to all of the entities that are displayed here on the list, but we want to choose Asset. As we hover over the linked row, we'll select the asset entity, where we can then see a list of all the fields on our asset entity. We choose Asset Status. This column is now showing the asset status for each task, and we'll see the field header displaying Link Asset Status. We call this bubbled fields, and though we may be focused on tracking tasks, we also want to bring in the asset status onto this task page so that we can always see the overall progress of the asset from this page. Now, we want to link time logs to shots and sequences, but first, let's take a step back and look at our project hierarchy. We have four entities linked together: sequences, shots, tasks, and then time logs. Remember that a single sequence contains many shots, while a single shot contains many tasks. We can pull the sequence name onto a page of time logs, since each time log is linked to only one task, and each task is linked to only one shot, and each shot is linked to only one sequence. We also see that the field connecting tasks to time logs is called Link. On our time log page, we scroll down to the linked field section again, and then go through link, task, link, shot, and navigate to the sequence field that's on shot. This will pull in the sequence name field onto our time log page. Now we can see on each time log the name of the sequence each time log's tasks shot is associated with. Let's adjust the formatting of the page a little, save it, and then let's group, sort, and filter by fields on linked entities and do more complex connections with multiple hops. First, let's filter our time log page by time logs only associated with shots. We can do this by creating a new page filter called Shots. Then, we make sure we are showing all time logs which match linked fields, link, task, link, is a shot. Now that we've filtered information that we want to see, let's sort by shot name. We navigate to the sort dropdown and then sort by link, task, link, as we can see since the time log tasks are linked to shots. Note that if the field was already displayed on the page, we could easily sort by it by clicking on the field header as well. Now, let's take it a step further and group these time logs by sequence. To do this, we'll navigate to the Group dropdown, Link Field section, Link, Task, Link, Shot, and then select Sequence. We can collapse these groups by alt-clicking on the headers. Now, let's see the sum of the duration per sequence. So let's right-click on the duration column and select Summary, Summary Calculation, Sum, and then show page column summaries. Notice how the data is summarized for each group, as well as for the whole page. Remember that we can only pull information through fields that are single entity links, not multi-entity links. In other words, we cannot pull information from an entity that is linked to many entities, like pulling task information onto an assets or shots page. This is because assets and shots can contain many tasks, so Shotgun won't know which task to pull information from. Instead, we use pipeline step columns to display this kind of information, or we can filter this information from a task page using the linked fields filter widget. Bubbled fields and linked entities work the same across different templates. So whether you're working on levels, spots, or episodes, you can find the same kind of links throughout. Now that we have an understanding of how things are linked together, let's walk through how we can create links between two entities where those links don't already exist. In this example, let's say we're doing episodic work. From a shots page, we can see that shots are linked to sequences that are linked to episodes, which are linked to the season. But in this scenario, we don't need to track sequences, so instead, we want to create a direct link from shots to episodes, and then hide sequences from this project. We can do this from our shots page by adding a new entity field on shots of the episode type. This will make it so that one episode can be linked to a shot. Once we create the field, we'll see that a reverse field is created on episodes that links multiple shots to a particular episode. Let's add some links. And everything is looking good now for both pages. Now, we head to our project's tracking settings, hide the sequence entity from the project, and then specify our new episode shot hierarchy via the shot entity. Now, we've set up the right linking and hierarchy for our episodic project and can bring in episode fields to our shots page. We'll cover more about tracking settings in the next topic.